Good day, Dobry dzień. Thank you for having me here. It's a pleasure for me to perform here. I'm coming from TÜV Nord, and TÜV Nord is a testing organization with around about 12,000 employees all over the world in 7 countries, especially in the Baltic. This is in Riga. This is the TÜV Nord Baltic, and I like to present you today a case study. This will be my main topic. And of course, the theme is quality assessment of buildings. But you will see the main topic. This will be the case study. And maybe this could be really interesting for you, because I will talk about the preventive fire protection theme, and also the theme, the topic of hazardous particles in the indoor air. This could be really interesting, it seems, for me. Okay, this is my agenda, and number one and two, this is a warm-up, if you so want, and number three, the case study, and four and five, if you have time, some conclusions and some advantages of the quality assessments of buildings and what can quality do for you. Okay. The point one, of course, this is quality in construction with regard to point A, technology, consistency, functionality of domestic installations, and stability. This is all that what you can grab. This, you can see it and you can feel it. You can smell it sometimes. And the B point is the mental attitude. This is what you can't see, what you can't feel, what you can't smell. And especially this could be the safety for life and health. Also, of course, high rate and elegance. Elegance is just something to feel. But the safety for life and health. Please recognize if a building, even high-grade building, not safe for health and life. The quality has absolutely no worth. And this is what I like to say. If you are a builder for new buildings, quality ensured by building code, by design, by financial budget, of course, by know-how, by controlling, and by documentation. If you have money enough, you can do everything, and if you like. But if you are a manager of existing buildings, it could be really complicated to make this, because every inadequacy could be possible everywhere, especially to safety for life and health. For construction years, approximately between 1955 and 1995 in East and West. I will present a little bit later an authentical case. This will be the case study. Yes, and our examinations demonstrate that almost every larger building, maybe office buildings, hospitals, schools, etc., even those in high-grade performance built between 1955 and 1995, does not meet the standards required for safety, for life and health. This is, remember, the mental attitude. This is something what you cannot grab. Examples, applications of hazardous materials which has potential to impurify the indoor air with cancer-producing particles like asbestos or polychlorinated bifenyls. And also the inadequate standards of preventive fire protection. The challenge for the TÜV Nord Group, and now I like to use the opportunity to introduce you a little bit of the TÜV Nord Group. I told you the TÜV Nord Group is a testing organization, maybe 12,000 employees working all over the world. And we have also a headquarter in the Baltic area. This is in, here in Riga, TÜV Nord Baltic. You see it, 22 years of experience and with a focus to the testing and analytic laboratories, Department of Construction, supervising Department of Industrial Energy Audit and Energy Efficiencies. And forget there's something? Yes, what? Did I forget something? No? Okay. Sorry. Yes, and for us, the challenges of maintaining proper technical conditions of buildings in the future. Owners must determine surveys and technical examinations by experts, and the challenge is recognizing and sourcing. Experts must be state-of-the-art, challenge education and advanced training, maintenance of quality. Owners must recognize the urgency and react accordingly. The challenge is recognizing and sourcing. The building site, monitoring and documentation, challenges for the experts, education, advanced training, maintenance of quality. So now point three, this is the case study I told it, and it's called structural maintenance in contaminated buildings. Contaminated, especially this means contaminated with asbestos. The object, this is the Leninsky Prospect 95A in Moscow. This was built in 1984 by the former East German government according to typical standards of the East Germany. Currently used by the German Consulate and the Goethe Institute, with round about 3,000 customers. It's really a public building. And the construction method, this is steel lattice framework combined with precast concrete components, cladding panels, and conventional interior fittings. So we have two problems there. This is an existing building, and we have to manage this existing building in the sense of quality. The problem number one is the steel lattice formwork is covered with asbestos spray. And what you see is a picture from the ceiling hollow, inside the ceiling hollow. And the potential is to impurify the indoor air with cancer-producing particles. Asbestos is really, really danger. It's still danger. In the World Health Organization says that 15,000 dead people in a year actually by asbestos is deplored. It's really a lot, 50,000 people. I think this is really a lot. And even asbestos is prohibited in Latvia since 2001, in Germany, for example, since 1993, and in Iceland, for example, since 1983, you can find in existing buildings, nearly in every existing building, which is a little bit larger, problems like that. And this is a risk that you contaminate every indoor place with this dangerous particles if you don't have the knowledge about these particles and this asbestos product. This is an authentic picture. I made it by my own. And the second problem there is the insufficient fire compartments which do not ensure escape in case of smoke and fire. Strengthening required subjects to the regulations in Germany, DIN 4102 is required. The DIN 4102 in Germany means fire behavior of building materials and building components. What you can see there is a big public room, really, really a big public room. You can see it a little bit later on a photo. And this is just one large compartment. And it was necessary to strengthen the walls that in smoke compartments. And remember, please, in 1996, there was a fire disaster in the terminal building of the Düsseldorf airport. And a lot of people are now sensitive in part of exactly this, the smoke protection, even in existing buildings. So the project definition for us, this means the TÜV Nord. Goal one, attain conditions equal to the effect of an asbestos abatement, so interim measures, because impossibility for technical organization, political reasons of removing the asbestos in a regular way, it was absolutely not possible to make a regular asbestos abatement there. And what we need is an average concentration significantly less than 100 particles per cube meter. This is approximately equal to the outdoor pollution in accordance with the German asbestos regulations. And the second goal is the strengthening the structural fire protection under physical safeguarding measures in case of constructional intervention. So the goal three is monitoring and documentation in accordance with the quality requirements of German regulations. You know it, this is a DIN ISO 9000, and also the competence of testing and calibration laboratories, DIN, the 17025. The realization there, and this is an example, semi-spatial separation of the asbestos products, asbestos dust removal in inner areas, and intervention strictly under quality monitoring. And the realization of the stringency of the structural fire protection. Example, physical safeguarding measures in the sense of engineering service. You remember the pictures a few minutes before? Sorry. What we need is to have smoke compartments, and we have to mount some F90 doors there. And it is absolutely necessary that no one of the workers destroy the contaminated ceiling hollows there. And this is one of the major points of the supervising to make this situation ensure. And yes, the realization of the monitoring, this is a little bit complicated because you cannot measure the indoor pollution in the same time, at the same place. You have to make a sampling, and after that you need a laboratory for the analytic with scanning electron microscope. You have to check the quality and the quantity, and of course you have to make a calculation and an assessment. The monitoring and supervising in the sense of expert testimony, we call it VDE 3492, and this is the standard for the scanning electron microscopy procedure there. And of course, please don't worry about these pictures. This is what you can make with quality elements of a testing laboratory. The documentation and, of course, the application beyond the standard estimation of uncertainty measurement, including arithmetic mean and 95% confidence level in the sense of Poisson statistic. This is really a good tool to handle these problems. And for the conclusion, if you use a quality system, the quality system of the laboratory we used, always asbestos monitoring with a quantification below the regular standards of single measurements as described in the regulations, I told you, which is usually not more sensitive than 100 particles per cube meter. We demonstrated 20 particles per cubic meter. This is really, really less. And this means 31 particles per cubic meter in the 95% confidence level. This is really, really, really good. And it's demonstrated the effect of the interim measure we have planned there is equal to the asbestos removal. The concentration of asbestos fibers in the indoor air are on the average approximately equal to the expected outdoor pollution. The advantages of this procedure: the procedure generates and demonstrates safety for both owner and occupants, even when circumstances award performance according to the regular requirements by law. This occurs in agreement with the German regulation Landesbauordnung, paragraph 3, and legal decisions are predictable when the laboratory quality system is officially accredited by maybe DAX, called in Germany. This is also the requirement for physical safeguarding measures in case of intervention, like strengthening the structural fire protection. Yes, and last but not least, thank you and have a nice day. Enjoy the event.
Thank you. Thank you, Thomas.